Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to another chillax session with Hakuna Lamisa and Mr. Ho.
Hello.
So what are we going to talk about today? So today's topic, as we all know, today is Hari Raya.
Selamat
Hari Raya. So we would like to wish all our friends who celebrate Raya a Selamat Hari Raya. Okay, let's get into today's topic. So today's topic would be about, let's share about what is our favorite experience or what do we like during Raya season in Malaysia. Okay, so first let's talk about the food. So is there any specific food that you enjoy during Raya?
Of course, nasi lemak. I enjoy every day. Even though Raya.
So during Raya, we have before the MCO, now before that, I used to go a lot of open house with my dad, where his friend would have open house. So we go there and have food. And oh, I love the rendang, the ketupat, and also especially the satay. I always would take the satay.
Yeah, satay is my favorite too.
It is, right? And basically every open house you have it. So even if one day we go to a few open house, like maybe two or three, I will still stick the same few items, which is number one must eat is satay. And then mostly sometimes they'll have nasi lemak, and then also rendang chicken. Oh, I always take their rendang chicken and ketupat. Ketupat is the best. But there is something also, I'm not sure whether you have had it before. It's something called lemak.
What is lemak?
Lemak is inside the buloh, you know. There's a long one. You see a lot of people sell during Raya or during Puasa near the roadside.
The buloh inside got the rice one.
Yes, that kind one. It's something like ketupat, but it's different. It's lemak. It's more sticky. That one, do you eat that before? If you ever eat that before?
Yeah, I think so. It's like what we call...
Pulut?
Yeah, pulut.
Yeah, it's something like a pulut, yeah. But between lemak and ketupat, I would rather take ketupat because I don't like it to be like too sticky and the texture is not there. I like the ketupat's texture a bit hard where I can chew it. Okay, so let's move on. What about the Raya song? Is there any Raya song that you enjoy?
Oh, balik kampung. Oh, balik kampung.
Yeah. You know, during the Raya holiday, right, before MCO, we usually would travel around. We were balik kampung also. So when we balik kampung, right, even if we never balik kampung, if we go, because it's a holiday on Raya, so we will go, maybe go shopping or anywhere. Then on the way on the car, we just love to, when this song come out, we just love to turn up the volume and sing together. Oh, bye. Balik kampung, as though as we are going to balik kampung, but actually we are just like enjoying the moment. It feels so good to have this song on the way back home. And another song which is very famous is the Selamat Hari Raya. That one is also a canonic song. That's also a iconic song. Like, it will be played every single year in Raya, during Raya. It's like a must song. And one of the song that I'm not sure, I think most of you guys, some you guys may heard of it, some of you guys may not, because this is quite a old song. It's called Anugerah Syawal.
How to sing?
It's like Anugerah Syawal seindah Ramadan. Yeah, ooh, Selamat Hari Raya. So this song is actually sang by Bang Face.
Bang Face?
Yeah, Bang Face is a band. It's a Malaysian band singer like that. So they have actually quite plenty of song that I like lah. So one of these that I really enjoy the most is this Anugerah Syawal. So those of you who have never heard before, you guys can go and search on YouTube. They still have it. I think it's like 2014 song.
Maybe?
Yeah. So accidentally everybody know our age now. My age frame. Yeah, I'm from that year, okay? So that is a very, very enjoyable song, and it's quite meaningful. So I'll play it for you later after this talk show, okay?
Good.
Okay, so what about, do you know one more thing that all of us, I'm sure even kids love the most during Raya?
What is that?
when you, what is that? It's something that come in an envelope. It's like every
the ang pao.
Yeah,
it's like a green pao.
Yeah, yeah. Chinese call it green pao because ang pao in Chinese is called ang is red, so it's red packet. So for Chinese, when we see raya is green, so we say green packet. But actually, in Malay, it's called duit raya. Okay, so everyone love duit raya, like even if you're a small kid or adult, who won't like getting money? Everybody like. So that is one of the part I enjoy. So usually during raya season, I will go visit my dad's friend because my dad has a lot of Malay friends. So they will just they will ajak the whole family to come for buka to their house to enjoy the meal, and then they will always give us duit raya. And it's like, oh, every time I get duit raya from the uncle, sometimes I even get from the nenek, you know.
Nenek also give?
Yeah, sometimes the house, usually the house, right, is the uncle only will give my, the pakcik will give me, and any other makcik.
And sometimes the whole family give you?
Yeah, sometimes the makcik, I feel so bad, you know, not makcik, the nenek. Nenek is so old, but nenek is so kind. She was like, ni, cium ambil. It's like, oh, okay, thank you so much. I feel so happy, even though it's like, of course, the amount is not big lah, but then it's the thoughts that count, you know, when you receive, you feel like, oh, they really just want to let you have fun and everything, or just to enjoy.
Last time I go one my friend, my teacher, my in the sekolah menengah kebangsaan time. My teacher, because our school is inside the jungle also. So my teacher also, the house is also inside the jungle. So we go to their house to open raya. Wow. And we can't find the house.
You can't find your teacher house.
Yeah, because the teacher house is inside the jungle. Then the jungle got a lot of small lorong like that. Then we are driving a car. And we go into a halfway. And we call the teacher. Where is your house? Wait. The teacher will ride the motorcycle and come and find us. mother, come. Yeah. Then they will guide us into a house in our place, the houses is inside the jungle and it's very independent one. They are not conjunct with other people's
houses. So it's like not a terrace house, like it's like one house here, one house there. Because your hometown is more like a kampong area, right? That's why it's more inside. So it's hard to find the exact location. It's not like it's apartment.
There is no GPS to
navigate. Yeah. But luckily your cikgu, he know how to find you guys, you know. I mean, at least he get to find you guys in the jungle. I mean, what if the teacher can't find you guys? You guys will just be lost over there.
Yeah, it's fine. We'll find some way to go.
Anyway, so did your teacher, what food did you have in your teacher place? Did you remember?
Food, I think it's rendang, and I had the most is, I think it's asam laksa.
Come on, asam laksa tastes so good.
I'm really scared of the sour smell of those.
You mean the fishy smell?
Yeah, and the fishy.
Come on, that's the best part.
The curry and the rendang is the best.
Curry, of course, curry and rendang is the best, but come on, asam laksa is good too, you know. Just for your info, okay, Mr. Ho here, he don't like anything that is fishy tasty, but I all do respect, I love asam laksa, okay? Any chance I have, I can get asam laksa, I'll just get it. Oh, okay, so other than the green pack, the duit raya, like there's one more thing that we miss, all of us, I think, which after having MCO for so long, I'm sure that all of us miss this during the raya season. And can you guess what is that?
What is that?
During MCO, we can't have this feeling at all.
What, the fireworks?
No, it's the jam. It's the Barik Raya jam. No. It is. You know, it's actually very fun. You know, I mean, like last time where before the lockdown, you feel like, oh yo, Balik Kampung got jam again, and then it's like so tiring. You need to stay in the car for so long and everything. But now being locked up at home for
you wish.
Being locked up at home for so long, right? You have the urge to feel the jam again. You want to feel the raya mood jam, you know?
You know, like yesterday I see a news. the people he want to go back to her hometown. Then she hide into the bonnet of the car.
Oh, you mean the the Indonesian one? Like there's a Indonesian woman. She's an Indonesian woman. Yeah, and then she want to go to another state. I think Malacca to meet up with her husband or something. So she went and called a Grab driver or e-hailing driver lah. And then she just like I think she tip off the driver to hide her to get it over. Yeah.
But then she
I saw
also
the news. But she
gonna
still
found out.
Yeah, she still gonna caught lah. I mean, I don't know how lah. I think maybe the police see like the car is a bit lower than normal.
Yeah, maybe they suspect they smuggling somebody.
Maybe the driver itself lah. Maybe the driver also panic. It's like he's panicked. That's why everybody suspect him lah. Maybe lah. Who knows? Okay, so. Anyway, the best part about Raya, the one whole thing that everybody truly enjoy doing Raya is actually the season, the environment, the atmosphere of the whole Raya, you know?
It is a family gathering time,
a friend gathering time, and it's a time for forgiveness, you know? Raya is actually all about forgiveness. You forgive whatever wrong that people have done to you, and you forgive yourself. So it's actually a very meaningful
festival.
It is. So once again, today is so okay. So today is this is our end of our 2 days chillax time. So once again, we would like to wish all our friends who celebrate Raya a
Selamat Hari Raya,
and see you guys on our next show. Bye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.